one has ever clapped me on
the
No!
So we take people, other people go out and have a lot, but we, I'd never been, the first day I went in there was the day when, and I was just unusual because I hadn't been a minister before and I came prime minister, so that's sort of unusual, but normally, yeah. So that's it, so yeah, yeah, so this was sort of, yeah,
they do vary on fire.
Is Ella from up there?
Yeah, no, yeah, we've got a few of them around too.
It's like a bloody winter
look here too.
No,
actually,
John.
Absolutely. Other one down the road, yeah.
A few interesting characters. Bit of a gimp suit act going on there. Not sure if those kids are safe. A few more people showing up. I think that might be Boca Juniors.
Yeah, 揸邊個後邊，個女仔公。
It's kind of similar to the American Cup parade, turn up. How does it make you feel?
That's pretty cool. I wasn't really around for that one, so I guess it's a similar place. Yeah, it's cool. It's
thoughts on the cannon, boys?
Council would like to thank all of the players and management teams here today who have agreed to take part in this nationally significant event. 8 months ago, just down the road at Westpac Stadium, an absolutely magnificent and memorable night. In fact, probably one of the most memorable nights in our sporting history. The win over Bahrain took the All Whites to the FIFA World Cup in South Africa. And we all know, of course, what happened after that. Three absolutely sensational games at the World Cup, and we've heard it thousands of times, haven't we? But the only unbeaten side at the FIFA World Cup.
I just want to say to the All Whites one thing. You made every New Zealander be incredibly proud with your performance in South Africa, and it's great to have you here and to celebrate your success, boys. It was an amazing effort. This is a team that had a huge amount of courage and guts and determination, and were just never prepared to give up. Whether it was in that last minute against Slovakia when Winston Reid got his goal, whether it was hanging on for the better part of 60 minutes against the former 2006 world champs Italy, or when they were up against Paraguay, the All Whites just showed New Zealand why they were so proud of this team. About 3 or 4 months before the event, Football New Zealand asked me whether I'd be patron for the 2010 campaign in South Africa. And I immediately said yes. I thought, look, what a great bunch of guys. Incredible result to get to the World Cup for the first time in 28 years. What I didn't know was a lot of the members of this team. And what I can tell you, as someone that's had an opportunity to be with them in South Africa, Italy, spent a bit of time with them most recently in my office, but in that time when I was over there and before we left, this is the most humble bunch of guys you will ever meet. They play as a team, they care about each other, they support each other through thick and thin, and they don't have an ego in amongst any of them. And when we flew back on their plane from Nelspruit in South Africa to back to Joburg, having drawn with Italy 1-1, it was a team that just knew they had to get on and do the business against Paraguay. And I think that's why they played so well. They managed to stick together, they looked after one another, and they played with a whole lot of pride from the people of New Zealand. So today's your day. I just simply want to say it's been a privilege to be your patron. I thank you for the opportunity to be with you. But most of all, on behalf of the people of New Zealand, thank you for taking us, putting us on the international stage, making us rub our eyes at 2 a.m. as we watch those TV sets and go, way to go always, you're the champs.